Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this next problem is not so pretty, but we're going to work through it. 3 halves times the natural log of 4x to the 10th minus 2 fifths times the natural log of 2y to the 15th. And we're trying to pull it all together, write it as a single log. Okay? Now, a little trick I'm going to show you before we start. I have a 2 over here and I have a 4 over here. What I'm going to do before I even really begin the problem is I'm going to rewrite this 4 as 2 squared. And of course I have x to the 10th there already. You may not understand why I did that, but I think you're going to understand it as the problem progresses. If I see a 2 over here, I want to see a base of 2 over here, because later on I may be able to do something with them. Okay? Let's focus here. This 3 halves has to get put back as a power. You know, it's the power rule backwards. I have the natural log of, I have 2 squared, but I'm going to be raising it to the 3 halves power. I have x to the 10th, but I'm going to be raising it to the 3 halves power. Okay? Let's keep working here. This is the natural log of. Okay, look what happens here. The 2 remains, the base of 2. But what happens here is this 2 cancels with that 2, leaving me with 3. What happens here, this 2 cancels into that 10 5 times. 5 times 3 is 15. So the front part of my problem becomes the natural log of 2 to the 3rd x to the 15th. I have a minus in the middle. Okay, follow me. This minus is here. This natural log, this 2 fifths, just in the previous example, doesn't just go to the 2, it also goes back on the y to the 15th. So I have 2 to the 2 fifths, and I have y to the 15th raised to the 2 fifths. Okay? So I have the natural log of 2 to the 2 fifths power. And then here on the y, 5 goes into the 15 3 times. 3 times 2 is 6. So we've made this a lot prettier. And we've made this a lot prettier. I mean, they're not pretty, but they're prettier than they were. If I have the natural log of a number minus the natural log of a number, that becomes the single natural log of the quotient. On top, we would have 2 to the 3rd x to the 15th. In the denominator, we would have 2 to the 2 fifths y to the 6th. Now, here is why I had you get a base of 2 earlier, okay? We have the natural log of. Now, there's nothing that I can do with the x to the 15th other than leave it. There's nothing I can do with the y to the 6th other than leave it. But I can simplify 2 to the 3rd divided by 2 to the 2 fifths. Okay, watch what we're going to do. You know that when you're dividing, exponents get subtracted. So 2 to the 3rd divided by 2 divided by 2 to the 2 fifths becomes 2 to the 3 minus 2 fifths. Okay? This 3 is really 3 over 1. To subtract these, I need to get a common denominator of 5. So I write 3 as 15 over 5, we pick up the minus 2 over 5, and that gives me 2 to the 13 over 5. Yuck. So this ugly thing becomes 2 to the 13 fifths power. This, my friends, is our answer to that nasty problem. Now, if I look back at their choices, let's see if I can focus in. They're tiny, but it looks like, let's see, it looks like it would be choice D. Yep, that matches us. The natural log of 2 to the 13 fifths x to the 15th over y to the 6th. Wow. Not that we can't do it, but let's hope there's not a lot of those on the final, right? I know how you feel about that one. But anyhow, there's a lot of good stuff in there for those of you especially going on into pre-calc. Okay?